This video is recorded in Home Designer Suite and applies to suite, architectural, and professional. In this video, we'll discuss how to record a walkthrough video. We'll start by drawing the walkthrough path, including drawing a path that extends to our second floor. Then we'll add keyframes to the path that allow us to adjust the view's height, speed, and orientation. And we'll finish by looking at the walkthrough options for recording along the path. I'll begin with a finished plan, ready for a walkthrough to begin. Under the 3D menu, I'll find the 3D walkthrough tools, and I'll select Create a Walkthrough Path. This is a spline-based object. To create a path with the tool active, I'll click and drag in the direction I want to walk. I like to draw in relatively short segments to maintain control over the spline. Then to continue the path, I'll put my cursor directly over the camera at the end of the current path and click and drag out a continuation. I'll continue to do this, moving the path towards the stairs. Then I can drag the camera and release at the bottom of the stairs and it will automatically climb the stairs for me. Now if I want, I can go upstairs and continue drawing the walkthrough path, but I'm going to end it there. I'll double-click on the spline path to open the walkthrough path specification. In here, we'll see a list of our keyframes. Note that they are numbered sequentially first to the last. You can insert additional keyframes in the plan. And when you insert one, they are added here and automatically renumbered in sequence. To add a keyframe, I'm going to exit out of this dialog, select the spline, select this Add Keyframe option in the Edit toolbar, and then I can click anywhere along the line to add a frame. The more keyframes you have along a path, the more control you have over the recording. You can also delete keyframes by opening the specification dialog, clicking on a keyframe, then selecting delete. The keyframe will be removed and the remaining keyframes will renumber to maintain the sequence. Each keyframe has properties you can view and adjust. For example, if I click on keyframe 1, we'll see it's on floor 1, though we could assign it to be on another floor. Another value you could see and adjust is the speed after in feet per second, which will define your walking speed from this frame until it reaches the next one. I'm going to reduce the speed after to 1 for every keyframe except the first to create a slower walk. For the first frame, I want to enter the house quickly, so I'll leave that one 3 feet per second. Camera angle adjusts the rotation of the camera in relation to the path. When at 0 degrees, the camera will simply follow the path as drawn. You can adjust the camera angle in plan view. If I exit out of this view and select the path, you can see that each camera has a move handle allowing you to move it in a different location on the path and rotate the handle so you can adjust the camera angle. Then when I open the line again and go to that frame, you can see the angle has changed and I can put in a different number if I want to. Tilt angle allows you to look up and down along the path. 0 degrees will look straight forward. If you have a ceiling detail or want to look up at upper cabinets, for instance, you can put a positive angle. If you want to look down at the floor, you can put a negative angle. For the first keyframe, I'm going to add a negative angle of -7.5. Finally, you can adjust the camera height off the floor. By default, we are 5 feet high, but you can raise or lower that depending upon what you want to look at. For this first keyframe, I'm going to set it to be 200 inches in the air. We'll start the recording up above the house looking down, then gradually approach the floor door. Once we've made the adjustments, you can see the time of the end recording here in walkthrough options. So in this case, the recording will be about 60 seconds long. Increasing the speed of the path or decreasing the length of the path will both decrease the overall time of the walkthrough. So now we'll select the line and in the Edit toolbar select Record Walkthrough Along Path. Here we'll have some additional options to control the recording. Compression has to do with the quality of the image. A value of 0 is the highest quality, but also increases the file size of the recording. A walkthrough is basically just a number of pictures taken along a line and woven together to create a video. The number of frames per second, therefore, is the number of camera shots the program will take per second of the recording. And remember, the number of seconds for the recording depends upon how long the line is and how fast we will be moving through each keyframe along that line. The more frames per second, the smoother the recording, but also the longer it will take to create the recording and the larger the file size of that recording. We're going to change this value to 30 frames per second to create a smoother video. You'll see this increases our total frames to record to 1,818 frames, meaning it's going to take that many pictures along the line. Here we can increase or decrease the resolution or size of images in the video. The larger the resolution, the clearer the image on the larger screen, but the recording will also take longer to generate a larger file size. We can change the rendering technique here and decide if we'll have shadows and bloom, which is a more realistic lighting effect turned on for our recording. And finally, we need to decide what type of video file we will produce. Then we'll select OK, decide where we want to save the video and what to name it. And then when I select Save, it will begin recording the video. Once the recording gets through all the frames, the recording will stop. To find the video you recorded, you'll need to go to the location on your machine where you saved it. You may find when you watch the video that you need to make changes and re-record. For instance, you might wind up going too fast at one point, in which case you would want to open up the walkthrough path and decrease your feet per second at that keyframe. Or you might not want to walk through a closed door, in which case you can select the door in question, then in the Edit toolbar, select Show Door Open in 3D. You can also adjust the spline itself. So if you move too close to a wall, you can select the line and use the Edit handles and adjust its shape. Then once you've made all your changes, you can select the walkthrough path and again select Record Walkthrough Along Path. So to record a walkthrough, you draw a walkthrough path, add keyframes to gain more control over where the camera is looking and how fast it is moving along the path, and then select to record the walkthrough and save it in a location on your computer. Then you can watch the video or take that file and send to someone else to view your home.